There's an old saying, God may have made the world, but the Dutch made the Netherlands. This is the Maasland Barrier, and it's one part of the Delta Works, a set of megastructures that hold back the ocean when high seas threaten to flood this country. This is one of the world's largest movable structures, a pair of 210-meter-long gates designed to seal off the main shipping route to Rotterdam Port and hold back storm surges. Depending on whose measurements you believe, somewhere between a fifth and a third of the Netherlands sits below sea level. A lot of that reclaimed from the ocean over years through managing marshland and moving earth and pumping water. There are areas of the Netherlands described as former islands. And these gates are part of the enormous system that Dutch engineers built to keep this country dry. And a couple of hours northeast of here is where they learned to do it. This is just one part of the 10 square kilometers of Waterloopbos, and it was built when the only way to simulate water was to use water. It's now a national monument, and nature is taking back these structures, these experiments.
Waterloop means how the flow runs through a system. That is Waterloop in Dutch. Over here we're mostly doing what we call model studies. So basically simulating nature at a certain smaller scale. The whole area started more or less after the Second World War, so around 1950, when there was a big demand for model studies related to the Delta Works in the southwest part of the Netherlands. It was for the Delta Works, but we also did many studies all over the world. Studies of the harbor of Libya, harbors in Tunisia, harbors in the Far East, Hong Kong. The main reason for building the Waterloopbos here is that we needed a lot of space for the models, because around 1950, all the models were outdoor. And another thing is, you need water. Where we are standing here is basically the bottom of the former Southern Sea. So we are here standing at a level, let's say, -2 or -3 meters below mean sea level. Here we have a natural water drop of about 5 meters. So we just have to open the gate at that part of the wood, and the water will flow freely through this area. We are standing in what we call the Delta Flume. An enormous rectangular box, so to say. And now you see more an artist impression of this flume, with certain section cut out and placed perpendicular to the original flume wall. In this flume, the studies are related to the design of breakwaters. These breakwaters are enormously costly, in the order of, let's say, 100 million euros. You take a section out of your breakwater and then scale it down to about 1 to 5 and test it here. I've been in meetings where they fight for every centimeter of the block. Well, if we propose, well, let's say that the block should be 1 meter, they ask, could not be the block 95 centimeters or 96 centimeters or 97 centimeters, because that is money. Each centimeter you can reduce on the block is money. And therefore, this was one of the cash cows of Delft Hydraulics, doing these studies, which are expensive, but still cheap in the design of a big breakwater. At the moment, the Waterloopbos is a kind of tourist attraction. The upcoming of the computer, that's one of the main reasons that this area was left around 2000. We do excursions for tourists to see how we operated the old outdoor models. And this flume is handed over to the Natural Monument Organization about 2 years ago. So although we left the territory in 2000, this flume was still operational for about 50 years, because you cannot easily replace this flume to another place.
The Water Act, part of Dutch law, requires the government to maintain flood defences, and it establishes a maximum risk that's allowed. So there are parts of the Netherlands that, in law, it must take a 1 in 10,000 year weather event to flood. The trouble is that the predictions for what 1 in 10,000 years involves keep getting worse. Since they were completed in 1997, the gates of the Maasland Barrier have only been closed in defence twice. But that's going to become more common in future. Flood defences that were researched here were designed to protect the cities and towns that people already lived in. But with those defences in place, people kept building, and the consequences of failure keep growing. The Dutch are going to have to keep making the Netherlands for a long time yet.